Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see a problem based on volumetric strain. For that, here we have a question. A mild steel flat 150 mm wide, I'll write that in the data. It is given that there is a mild steel flat which is 150 mm wide by 20 mm thick. So width is 150 mm, thickness is 20 mm and 6 meter long, length 6 meter, so it is 6000 mm. Carries an axial pull of 300 kN. Load is given, so it is 300 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. If modulus of elasticity of mild steel is 200 kN per mm square, modulus of elasticity capital E, 200, it is given kN, so I'll multiply it by 1000 to get it in terms of Newton per mm square. And Poisson's ratio mu is 0.25. The question is, calculate change in length, the first part. Next, change in width, delta B. Change in thickness, delta T, and at last, change in volume of the flat. So these are the questions in front of us. Whatever is given, we can start solving the problem from that. But before I start, in the solution, I'll draw the diagram. It is given that it is a mild steel flat, so the cross section is rectangular. It is having rectangular cross section. So this is the diagram. Mild steel flat is having width B. B is 150 mm. Then thickness is given as 20 mm, which is T is equal to 20 mm. Next, the length is given as 6 meter, or we can say 6000 mm. Length is given. Then it was said that it carries an axial pull of 300 kN. So there is a pull type of load of 300 kN. So along the axis of this, there is a pull type of load which will be trying to pull this rectangular block. And because of this pulling action, this load is parallel to length, which is 6000. So along the length, there will be linear strain, that is, length will increase and the other two dimensions B and T will decrease. So for B and T, we would be using lateral strain. So now, first of all, in the solution part, I'll say that since cross section area of a rectangular flat, it is given by A is equal to B into T. So therefore, capital A is equal to B is 150, T is 20. So therefore, area comes out to be 3000 mm square. Now after getting the area, I can even calculate the volume. I'll say that therefore volume of rectangular bar is given as V is equal to area into length. So therefore volume becomes, area is 3000, length is 6000 in terms of mm. So volume will be 18 into 10 raised to 6 millimeter cube. Now after getting the area and volume, Now I'll try to get the solution one by one. The first thing is change in length, which is also called as deflection. So here we can say that since deflection in the bar is given by, the formula is delta L is equal to PL upon AE. So therefore deflection becomes P, the value is given in the problem of P, it is 300 kilonewton. So I'll write down 300 into 10 raised to 3 newton multiplied by length is 6000 mm divided by area is 3000 into Young's modulus is 200 into 10 raised to 3. So from this I'll get the answer of deflection, which is, it comes out to be 3 mm. And as we can see in the diagram, when the load is applied parallel to the length and it is a pull type of load, then this length will increase. So this 3 mm indicates increase in length or elongation, we can say. And this is the first answer. Now, after getting change in length, we need to find out change in width and change in thickness. For that, we require lateral strain. And lateral strain will be in the formula of mu, which is Poisson's ratio. So next, I'll say that since Poisson's ratio is given by mu is equal to, it is lateral strain upon linear strain. Lateral strain is E suffix L, linear strain is small e. So therefore, lateral strain E suffix L is equal to mu into linear strain. Mu value is given as 0.25 into linear strain is change in length upon original length. So therefore, lateral strain will become 0.25 into deflection is 3 and length is 6000. So therefore, lateral strain will be 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 4. And here even I'll write the separate value of delta L by L. So therefore, this is called as linear strain. So 3 by 6000, that value comes out to be 5 into 10 raised to minus 4. So here I have found out both the values, linear strain, lateral strain. Next, the question is to find change in width. So I'll use lateral strain because it is the lateral dimension. As length increases, width decreases. So therefore, lateral strain E suffix L is equal to change in width, which is delta B upon original width, which is B. So therefore, lateral strain is equal to delta B upon B. Now, after getting this, I'll write down lateral strain is change in width upon original width, and here we want this change in width. So delta B will be lateral strain into the width, which is original. Lateral strain is 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 4. Original width is given in the problem as 150 mm. So it is into 150. So therefore, change in width, the answer comes out to be 0.01875 mm. And as we can see here, when the load has been applied, it is parallel to length. Length will increase, width and thickness will decrease. So this value indicates there is decrease in the width. And this will be the second answer. Next, once we have found out the change in width, the next question was to find the change in thickness, and again I'll use the same concept. I'll write down also lateral strain is equal to change in thickness upon original thickness. So therefore change in thickness is lateral strain into thickness. Lateral strain is 1.25 into 10 raised to minus 4, and the original thickness was given in the problem, it was 20. So into 20, so therefore the change in thickness, my answer is 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. And again, as I have explained, when the load is parallel to length, length will increase, and since it is a pull type of load, that is why length will increase and the other two dimensions should decrease. So width has decreased and even this thickness is decreased. So this is the third answer. Now comes the last part of the question. They are saying to calculate how much is the change in volume. So for that we should use the volumetric strain formula. So first I'll write down, since volumetric strain is given by, the formula is volumetric strain is equal to E, which is linear strain, into 1 minus 2 mu. This is the formula. So therefore volumetric strain becomes, E is the linear strain, the value was 5 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 1 minus 2 into mu. Mu is given as 0.25. So from this I will get the answer of volumetric strain, E suffix V, and that volumetric strain, it comes out to be, the answer is, we can find the volumetric strain in such a way that we can directly get the change in volume. So it is also equal to change in volume upon original volume. So therefore change in volume will be EV into volume. This change in volume we have found out, I'll write it as it is, the volumetric strain 5 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 1 minus 2 into 0.25, using the same value multiplied by the volume, and volume it was 18, we have found out it was 18 into 10 raised to 6. So from this I'll directly get the value of change in volume, which is 4500 mm cube. So this much is the change in volume, which is the fourth answer. So here if we look into the question, they had told us to calculate these four values. Change in length, we have found out it was 3 mm. Next, the change in width we have calculated, it was 0.01875 mm. Next, change in thickness, 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. At last, the change in volume, which is 4500 mm cube. And once we have calculated all the values, the problem is completed.